From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
And I'm Erin O'Valley. The U.S. Marshal's office is offering a $500 reward for any information leading to the arrest of David Hobson, who escaped from jail in New Hampshire 5 days ago.
33-year-old is 5 feet 6 inches tall, we are told, and weighs 135 pounds. Investigators say he has a shaved head and a goatee, and he was last seen wearing a gray sweatshirt and sweatpants. Hobson also is believed to have cut himself on the razor wire fence as he escaped. Now, yesterday, authorities focused their search on the new dam road that's in Sanford, where several of Hobson's relatives live. Investigators say he was injured during his jailbreak, and they found a first aid kit behind his aunt's home, indicating he had been there. Hobson's family is urging him to turn himself in to police.
Testimony will continue this morning in the bail hearing for Buddy Robinson.
He has pleaded not guilty to the murder of Christiana Fesmeyer. She disappeared in July. Police have not yet found her body. News 8's Dave Guthrie has more.
Well, later today, the Buddy Robinson bail hearing will enter its third day here at Androscoggin County Superior Court in Auburn. The 30-year-old Robinson is charged with the murder of 22-year-old Christiana Fesmeyer, who disappeared in July. Both are from Lewiston. Now, authorities believe that Robinson drowned Fesmeyer in the bathtub of her apartment, and Robinson has been held without bail and pleaded not guilty in the killing. Investigators say that Fesmeyer worked for Robinson's sister as part of an online prostitution ring. And during a bail hearing last week, a woman who worked for Robinson's sister testified that the sister told her Buddy Robinson killed Fesmeyer. It's important to note that Fesmeyer's body has not yet been recovered. And we'll, of course, have the latest developments regarding this case available on our website, WMTW.com. For now, in Auburn, I'm Dave Guthrie for News 8.
Well, fire destroyed a vacant two-story apartment building near the corner of Osgood and Mexico Avenues in Mexico. Firefighters were called to the building at about 12:30 this morning. Mexico Fire Chief Gary Wenzel tells News 8 the entire building was engulfed in flames when they arrived on the scene. And we're going to show you some video off of YouTube. The chief says the building was undergoing renovations and had no power at the time. He also has asked the fire marshal's office now to investigate.
More details are expected this afternoon about budget cuts for the State Department of Health and Human Services. Governor Paula Page has a new plan that he says would eliminate a $120 million budget deficit. During his weekly radio address, LePage said the state cannot continue to foot the bill for the Medicaid program. LePage says that providing health insurance for almost 20,000 low-income single adults has cost the state almost $40 million. Over 2 years.
Two main cities have adopted opposite ordinances dealing with the sale of consumer fireworks. First, in Auburn, the city council unanimously approved banning the sale of fireworks. And then last night, that was the second and final reading. But then in Westbrook, the city council there decided to allow fireworks sales. However, officials set requirements for businesses to have a license in order to sell them. Earlier this year, the state did legalize fireworks, but allowed cities and towns the right to create and regulate their own laws. And that's going to do it for this News 8 update now. I'm Erin O'Valley.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us. We'll bring the latest forecasts and sports highlights in just a few minutes. We'll be right back.